Oh. Good morning and welcome to those who are watching our worship together this morning live around the world. It's delightful, not that you're here, but of course it is, but we're able to worship once again in this sacred space together. Our time together this morning is different. But I hope you leave uplifted, worshipful, with God in the centre of your lives and hearts, and leave this place refreshed and renewed. Let us be still for a moment.
As we gather here together after so long, let us sit. We sit still in the presence of God. Make yourselves comfortable. And just feel the quiet and the peace gather around you. You don't have to do anything. Just be. be aware of your breath as it comes gently in and out of your body. And let any thoughts come in and out just as gently. No need to hang on to them now. They will keep till later. All we are doing is sitting, being, letting God look at us. Close your eyes or leave them open as you wish. And we will sit in quiet together for a few minutes.
As we leave the silence and the isolation of being alone, we come together once more as a worshipping community. We join our thoughts and our prayers together. We give thanks for the love of God we find expressed among us, in our families, in our friends, and in one another. We give thanks for our health and well-being in the ongoing pandemic, and continue to pray for all those involved in healthcare, for doctors and nurses, for administrators, researchers, for ambulance staff and carers. We pray for those in government responsible for the policy which affects the welfare and livelihood of so many, asking for wisdom and compassion in their work. As the lockdown eases, we pray for those for whom the process is challenging and fearful, for the housebound and the frail, for those who continue to be shielded, and for those who care for them, and for all who are suffering mentally or emotionally. We pray for those holidaying in our county, and for those whose livelihood depends on them, that we may all grow a sense of mutual responsibility and care for one another. We continue to pray for those we know who are ill, whether from coronavirus or other conditions. Among them, we remember Bridget and Betty, and all in our nursing homes, for Chris, Luke, for Jed and Rosie, Andrew and Linda, Chris and Elaine, and anyone else close to our hearts. And finally, we pray for those we love but see no longer, especially for those who have died in these past few months since we last met. Among them, we remember Sylvia, Peter, Don, Roy, Henry, and any others known to us. Keep us, good Lord, under the shadow of your mercy. Support and sustain the anxious. Be with those who care for the sick, and lift up all who are brought low, that we may find comfort, knowing that nothing can separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Still for the presence of the Lord, upon you are his fear.
Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven."
Blessed are those who stayed indoors when they were asked to, for they have protected others. Blessed are the unemployed and the self-employed, for their need of God is great. Blessed are the corner shopkeepers, for they are the purveyors of scarce things. Blessed are the delivery drivers and the postal workers, for they are the bringers of essential things. Blessed are the hospital workers, the ambulance crews, the doctors, the nurses, the care assistants, and the cleaners, for they stand between us and the grave, and the kingdom of heaven is surely theirs. Blessed are the checkout workers, where they have patience and fortitude in the face of overwork and frustration. Blessed are the refuse collectors, for they will see God despite the mountains of waste. Blessed are the teachers, for they remain steadfast and constant in disturbing times. Blessed are the church workers, the deacons, priests, and bishops, for they are a comforting presence in a hurting world as they continue to signpost towards God. Blessed are the single parents, for they are coping alone with their responsibilities and there is no respite. Blessed are those who are alone, for they are children of God, and with him they will never be lonely. Blessed are the bereaved, for whom the worst has already happened. They shall be comforted. Blessed are those who are isolated with their abusers, for one day, we pray, they will know safety. Blessed are all, during this time, who have pure hearts, all who still hunger and thirst for justice, all who work for peace, and who model mercy. May we know comfort. May we know calm. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Amen.
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory, for ever and for ever. Amen.
Creator, compassionate, healing God. You have brought our paths together and led us to this day. Go with us now through our meetings and our partings. Be with us through good times and through change. Make us worthy of one another's best and tender with each other's dreams. And may we reach old age in the company of friends. In the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and those you love, now and always. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.